Hi, and welcome to Deployment Using the System Center Configuration Manager. This is a module within the Microsoft Virtual Academy course of migrating from Windows XP to Windows 8.1. My name is Kyle Rosenthal. I am a Microsoft MVP, as well as a Microsoft Certified Trainer. If you do need to get a hold of me, if you want to ask any questions about the course, give me any feedback, then please feel free to use my Twitter handle into there, and I'll attempt to get back to you to answer your questions. Let's get dug in. So the course, like the module for today, is looking at the System Center Configuration Manager, which is part of the System Center family. So System Center 2012 R2 Configuration Manager is what we're looking at from within here. And we're going to look at some of the concepts of zero-touch deployment, and what it actually is and what it can do for us, as well as looking at how to integrate Microsoft Deployment Toolkit into System Center Configuration Manager, and as well as that, why you might do that, because that's always an important question. So zero-touch deployment, let's have a quick sort of overview of it. We're going to have a look at some of the things that are contained within it. But what zero-touch deployment is it's using the ability to be able to have a deployment that has little or no configuration or like interaction from the user or from a technician to be able to have a deployment process. Okay. Now the idea of this is really it's fully automated. Now we can have it so that it's like a bare metal environment. So say for instance a new machine comes into the environment and we push an operating system out onto it. Or alternatively, if we've got all of our Windows XP environment that we now want to migrate across into Windows 8.1, then we can automate that process by creating advertisements to be able to have or deployments to be able to push out to all of our XP boxes, and then have that process occur for us to be able to do the deployment, the migration. But as much as possible, what we want to do is we're doing all of the process automatically, so that then we can essentially do a set and forget for our deployment, and users just end up with a new operating system. Of course, one of the main things that we want to make sure that we do for our users is we do want to make sure that we have things like the operating system migration as well for their USMT, so the user state. So don't forget about this. The user state, though, if we're doing it from going from Windows XP across to Windows 8.1, we do need to make sure that we're doing two different versions of scan state and load state. So it will require you to use the old version of scan state and the new version of load state. So when we're doing our USMT task sequence, we do need to make sure we call out the right version of the migration process. And so what you'll need to do is you'll need to make sure that you have two different packages that you create, one which is for our older version and one which is for our newer version. When we're doing our deployment, the deployment purpose, if we're doing a zero touch, we're pushing it out, we're forcing it out, so therefore we always make sure we push it as being a required installation. We do need to make sure that we can use the wake on LAN. And the idea of doing wake on LAN is it gives us the ability to be able to do this after hours without having someone go and power machines on. I can actually just simply send out the magic packets and get the operating system to wake up and have a deployment. So therefore, I could do this as an overnight process. Users go home, come back the next day, and they're refreshed into the new environment. And that's the beauty of zero touch, is that it gives us the ability to be able to do that without having the users actually having to interact with the environment at all. We do have the ability to be able to schedule for a later time if need be, okay? Or alternatively, we can schedule it to be as a mandatory assignment right now. Now, just be careful if you are doing mandatory assignments, if you're making it so it has to be done right this very second. And the main reason I say be careful of that is because it does make sure, you do need to make sure that you test this before you get to that level. because you want to make sure that that everything is working properly, that your capture is working properly, your deployment's working properly. Okay, so make sure, as I said, you take that process in into consideration. Generally, what I'll do is if I'm doing a deployment of any kind, is I kind of have a test bed that I'll work with. I'll certainly have a test environment, which is my first, making sure that everything physically works. And then as I roll out to the users, I'll roll out to a small group of users to start off with, then scale out, then scale out, then scale out, rather than simply going a full big bang deployment for everything that's in my environment right away. So one of the things that we can do is we can do an installation of the MDT into Configuration Manager. And one of the things that I kind of get asked often when I suggest this is, why do you do that? Because, the Configuration Manager on its own can do deployment, no hassles whatsoever. Microsoft Deployment Toolkit on its own can do deployment, no hassles whatsoever. But by combining the two, what it gives us the ability to do is it gives us the ability to be able to automate in a easy fashion, so using some guided wizards and step-throughs, to be able to create the deployments without having to start with a blank task sequence, trying to work out what we need to do. So it kind of gives us the ability to be able to do a template, if you like, to be able to then work our deployments on. So we can then use our task sequences within MDT, for MDT task sequences within Configuration Manager. Now, what I mean by that, make sure we're clear, we can't use the task sequences that you might have created within MDT. So say, for instance, if you've gone and created custom task sequences, we can't use those across in Configuration Manager. What we can do, though, is we can use the MDT task sequence templates to be able to create or to be able to recreate those task sequences in Configuration Manager. So the prerequisites that we've got put into place within here, the configuration, so we need to have Configuration Manager, the CAS permit, we need to have CAS permissions, we need to have site server permissions, we also need to have SQL Server administrative permissions, if we're leveraging off the MDT database. But the implementation, how we put it into place, we install MDT 2013. We have to install that on the same box that has Configuration Manager installed on. And then there's an option within the MDT menus to be able to then integrate within System Center 2012 R2 Configuration Manager. And then once we've got that put into place, we can then go ahead and create an MDT task sequence from within Configuration Manager to deploy a new machine using the MDT task sequence. Okay, so let's now have a look at what System Center 2012 R2 Configuration Manager looks like for us, and in particular, obviously, for our deployment area, what sort of things to look for from within there. So I've got Configuration Manager installed. I've got it opened up into here. We have the software library. Now, the software library is made up of a few different areas. There's certainly application deployments within there. There's also software updates, so the replacement for what used to be the WSUS sort of environment. But the one that we really care about for the purpose of this course is the operating systems. And if we expand that out, what we'll see into there is a whole bunch of sort of things that'll be of assistance to us. Certainly, there's a way to be able to have our drivers. And what I can do is I can add additional drivers that I may not have contained within my images that I want to be able to have added in. So let's grab those into here. And I've got the device drivers that are listed. Okay, now what I can do is I can either grab those from an INF file to be able to push that in, or alternatively, in this case, there's just a bunch that actually live within that UNC path, and I can select which ones I want to be able to put into place. I can also assign categories to those, if there's particular categories I want to have, so that I can then, it makes it easier to manage once you start having a lot of different drivers. And also if there's a driver package that I want to be able to use. And the idea with these is that if I am wanting to be able to do my, if I'm wanting to create a package of, say, a package of drivers for a particular version or particular type of hardware, say for instance there's a make or model that has unique drivers, then I can create a driver package to be able to add into that. But otherwise, for the moment, I'm going to, you know, see if there's anything that I need to update. Say, for instance, if there's a network driver that's in some new machines, and those network drivers need to be updated. So that's then going to update the Windows PE environment. And in this case, again, I'm just going to make it very simple, and we're not going to put that into place. But that'll then import the drivers for us. And once that's completed doing the import, what we'll then see is we'll then see it showing in the drivers environment. And again, depending on how many drivers we have, will depend on how long that sort of process will actually take to complete. Within the drivers area as well, we can actually have different folders that we put into place as well, just to make your life easier as well. So, you know, go ahead and create a new folder within there, and the idea being that you could then use that to be able to filter and manage your environment too. Operating system images, obviously for our deployment purposes, that's really important to have. Okay, so I've got a reference image deployment to here. This is one that's been captured. This is my reference image that I could use to be able to deploy out. But equally, I could use, have an operating system installer. And with that, that's actually the base information that I would be able to use to do my deployment. So there's sort of two steps to this. We can use Config Manager to be able to do the management, as we've discussed, of the creation of an image, as well as the ongoing management or the deployment afterwards. So the installer just simply does the installation of the box up front. And then once we've got that created, we can then create the images to be able to use. And we also need the boot images to be able to do the deployment configuration in the first place. But the thing that sort of holds it all together, the glue that does it all, is the task sequence. Now, the idea with the task sequence is it gives us the ability to be able to create a set of steps that we would do manually. And this is where the zero-touch installation comes in. So we have a couple of ones that I've got in here. I've got one which is actually doing a deployment, a build, and then a capture of an image. And what that does is that it will then create a reference image, which I would then use to be able to deploy out using my target computer deployment. So if we open this up and have a look, what you'll see is that it has the task sequences that go along essentially looks at doing things like formatting the machine to start off with, making sure that we've got enough disk space for it to be able to operate into, and then doing the installation process, and running the operating system deployment, capturing the information contained within it. And the idea is, like, we can take these task sequences, we can move them around as we need to, we can modify them as we need to, we can make changes to them as we need to be able to suit your environment. For my target computer deployment, when I go to actually do the deployment of my reference machines, essentially what it does is it gives me the ability to be able to create or to be able to deploy if I'm doing a refresh. So a refresh, taking out the new machine, or so taking out an existing operating system and refreshing it, or if I'm doing a new machine, or sorry, if I'm doing an upgrade to a machine, I can then do things like the state capture. In order for the state capture to work, don't forget I have to have a package in order for that to work, and the package being my USMT package to be able to deploy out for that to work. If we're using hard link migration, remember that what we have to do is we have to make sure that we don't do any formatting of the disk. Instead, we just simply use the inbuilt system deployment to deploy around the operating system that already exists. So therefore, you know, kind of there are some things you'll need to take into consideration depending on the environment that you're using and depending on how you're using the various different tools that are available. To create those task sequences, that's using either creating a task sequence or alternatively creating the MDT task sequence. Now, creating the MDT task sequence, you have to have installed and configured the Microsoft Deployment Toolkit on the Configuration Manager environment. And then, once you've done that, you then will have the ability to be able to use the MDT sequences to be the MDT tools to be able to create your task sequences. And remember that the reason we do that is simply because it might give you a better head start in order to be able to do your deployments. Okay. So once we've got whatever it is that we're going to be doing our deployment, then what we do is we need to create the deployment process, and that is by deploying the content. Okay, and the task sequence that we're doing is the one that we've created, or that we've selected, and then the collection that we will be targeting. Now, in the case of doing an upgrade from a Windows XP environment, essentially what we're doing is we're going to be migrating from XP, so our reference machines would all be the XP environments, the Windows XP boxes that we're targeting from within here. So we'd select that particular, like that machine, or that collection, and then advertise into there. Okay, and we would do it as a required update to be able to force the process, and we would schedule it to create the schedule to assign it as soon as possible. And depending on what we're, like, you know, what the operating system is we're deploying, in this case 8.1, depending on what we're deploying to, we're probably not going to be worrying about going to the Windows embedded devices. We do need to make sure that we advise people that we're actually going to be running this. How much interaction we want to have, we can decide from within there. And then what distribution point we're going to be using it from, whether we're going to be downloading from the remote accounts, or sorry, if we're going to pull the information down as we need it from the distribution points, or alternatively if we're going to pull it all the way down and then then load, and then apply the distribution, apply the advertisement to be able to do the deployment. Now, what that will do is then it will then force the machines to be able to then check to see if there's actually XP boxes will now be looking to see if there's anything for them to be able to deploy, and then essentially kick off the process. So, as I said, what I would do is I'd be telling you users, look, this is coming, and schedule it so that when you actually do your advertisement, first off, make sure you're advertising to exactly the right group that you want to do. Now, I did it to the unknown computers in there. That's not the group you're going to do it in a production environment. You're going to put it to your XP environment, your XP boxes. You're also going to be putting it to a test environment to start off with. Okay, so make sure you do it to a test to start off with. Then check to make sure it works. Check to make sure that USMT works for how you've got things set up. Once you've got USMT put into place, once you do your deployment, make sure that the load state works to be able to deploy out the settings afterwards. So you want to make sure that you actually test everything before you go full scale with your deployments. And then, as I said, warn your users that this is coming. It's not necessarily going to be a quick process for them. It will take a few minutes. So therefore, you need to make sure that they're aware that they may be out. So like maybe without the machine for a period of time. This is something you might want to schedule for after hours. So therefore, use the wake on LAN to be able to do the magic packets to be able to wake up the machines to process the deployment. That's a very brief overview of Configuration Manager. As part of the TechNet Virtual Labs, there's actually quite a few system center labs that are available, and more that are coming that'll give you some assistance to be able to sort of have some hands-on with doing some deployments within the configuration manager and also just the general system center environment. So in summary, zero touch installation. What is it, and what does it do for us? Essentially, it's that the ability to be able to have a hands-off deployment, which we can then advertise deployments out to machines in order for them to be able to do the migration from XP across to Windows 8.1 with no user interaction and no administrative interaction. Obviously a bit of work to be able to get to that point, but once it's put into place, then essentially it does it all for us. And then also the looking at integrating MDT into System Center Configuration Manager and why we might do that. So making sure that, you know, we're aware that what that does is add additional task sequence templates that we can use within Configuration Manager in order to be able to make our life easier as administrators. So some useful links for you. The Configuration Manager 2012 R2 overview, as well as a really good blog site for doing any sort of deployment. Make sure you have a look at the Deployment Guys blog site. These are all of the field guys that actually go out and do deployments with customers, and all the hints and tips that they come up with, as well as the Springboard series. The Springboard series is an IT Pro series for it's a series for IT pros that actually gives some insight into doing things, not only deployment but also management of say for instance Windows 8.1. Gives you some hints on usage and that sort of thing that you might then be able to use to be able to push out to your users, and also the Microsoft Deployment Toolkit blog site as well. So the MDT team actually have a blog site to be able to have a look at some of the tools. Have a look at the tool of MDT and some advanced sort of usage cases that you might see from within there. So in summary, this is part of the Microsoft Virtual Academy. And again, this is one of the modules within the ongoing course. So make sure you do check out the other modules of the Windows XP to Windows 8.1 course. And also have a look at any of the other topics that might be of interest for you as well. Make sure you do visit the TechNet Eval Center and download any of the evaluation software bits that you might need to be able to set up your own test environment or test lab to be able to have a play around with the tools that we're looking at. Particularly with something like Configuration Manager, it's something that you can't, you won't just necessarily be able to pick up straight away. It will take a little bit of time to be able to get into what we're actually doing within Configuration Manager. Which then leads me to making sure you check out the IT camps to be able to see if there are courses that might be of assistance to be able to push you in the right direction, and get the word of mouth, advice straight from the mouths of the experts on how to actually use the tools that we've been looking at, as well as other tools that are available as well. So my name, as always, has been Kyle Rosenthal. Please make sure you visit us again for the next module within the course. If you do have any questions, then please make sure you let me know via the Twitter handle that was at the top of the deck. Thank you very much, and have a great day.